Hi everyone, this is Hillary from Elements, and today we're going to move through a yoga routine on the floor. So make sure that you've got a clean workspace and a comfortable yoga mat to support you. I'm going to be incorporating the use of, you could use a yoga strap, I'm going to be using this elastic tubing, you could even use a belt just to help extend the arms and stretch some of the leg muscles. So let's go ahead and find a comfortable position laying on your back on your mat.
All right. So let's begin by laying down with your knees bent and your feet on the floor. You might tuck your shoulder blades underneath. And let's just start to tune into your breath. So maybe you bring one hand to your heart and one hand to your stomach and feel your breath move through your body. Feeling the floor fully support you. Even out and slow down your breath. And let's go ahead and allow your arms to rest down alongside your torso. And we're going to inhale to lift the arms up. And then exhale, arms down. Just slow movements, breathing in. And breathing. Imagine your hands are moving through water or just a slight resistance. Breathing in and breathing out. Now you can stay here or inhale your arms up. And you have the option to exhale your arms towards your head, towards the floor. Inhale back up and exhale. Maybe if you are reaching above your head, maybe your arms can just go a little bit of the ways towards the floor. Maybe they just go a little bit. And then inhale back up. And exhale down. Good. And then go ahead and rest your arms on the floor. You might turn your palms up and tuck your shoulder blades underneath you. And this time, let's bring that right knee in towards the chest. Allow your left leg to extend out long. So you can support that right leg with your hands, either on the shin or on the thigh. And just finding a passive stretch here. Lengthening through some of those hip flexors. And then let's switch sides. Left knee in towards your chest, extending the right leg long, holding onto the shin or onto the back of your thigh. Good. And then let's go ahead and bring both knees in, and maybe you rock side to side a little bit, massaging your back. And then we'll go ahead and plant your feet on the floor. With your hands down alongside your hips, we're going to inhale to lift your hips off the floor. So make sure that you're keeping your chin lifted, your gaze towards the ceiling, and you're maintaining that open airway. With your hips lifted, you might tuck your shoulder blades underneath you. Maybe you bend your elbows, reaching your fingertips towards the ceiling. Maybe you allow the arms to fall out to either side. Pressing through the heels of your legs underneath you. Keep your gaze lifted towards the sky or the ceiling. And then exhale, pressing through your heels, lift your hips. You might tuck your shoulder blades underneath you once your hips are lifted. Bring the right knee to cross over your left ankle. So we're going to flex the right ankle. Sorry, the right ankle is crossing the left thigh. So you might stay like this, or if you want to deepen the stretch, you can lift your left foot off the floor, bringing both legs closer to your chest. And you might interlace your hands around your left. Then you should be able to keep your upper body relaxed. It's important that your upper body is relaxing on the floor. So if in order to interlace your hands around that back thigh, you have to lift your head and your shoulders, then it's best just to let your arms relax down. Just let your lower body do the work. Now you might try extending that left foot up towards the ceiling or keeping it bent. And then go ahead and lower your foot to the floor and uncross your legs. Let's switch sides. Now the left ankle crosses over the right thigh, flexing your right ankle to protect the knee. Now you can stay here or lift that right foot off the floor, bringing both legs closer to you. To interlace your hands around that right thigh to deepen the stretch. And then exhale, lower your feet to the floor and uncross your legs. All right, now it's time to locate that strap. So whether you've got a yoga strap or a belt or this elastic tubing, go ahead and locate it. And then see if you can place it around the bottom of your right foot. And we're going to reach that right foot up towards the ceiling. So you can keep your left knee bent and the foot on the floor, or you can extend that left leg out long. So the strap acts like an arm extension so that you can put a little bit of pressure and support onto that right leg to deepen that hamstring stretch. So we're focusing this stretch on the back of your right leg. So maybe you aren't able towards the ceiling and switch your grip. Now the left hand holds on to the strap and the right hand can come out to the right side. As that right leg comes across your body to the left side. So this can be just a small movement or it can be a larger movement. Trying to keep that leg straight. Find the center of your strap or your belt and we'll place it around the bottom of your left foot and extend that left foot up towards the ceiling. And you can keep your right knee bent or extend that right leg long. And just start to breathe into that hamstring stretch, drawing your leg a little closer towards your chest. Holding the handles of the strap on that same side arm, we're going to bring your right hand to your right hip and take that left leg out to the side. So maybe it just moves a little bit. That right hand is going to keep your right hip anchored to the floor. So maybe you can take your leg out a little bit wider. Right hand holds onto the strap and the left arm comes out to the side, bringing your left leg across your body. So maybe you just hold it here and you might even feel a stretch on that outer left hip. Maybe you allow the left hip to lift off the floor and bring your left leg across your body to the right side, making sure to keep your left shoulder on the floor. You might keep your gaze up towards the ceiling, doing whatever supports your head and neck the best. Inhale, back up to center, and exhale, lower your foot to the floor. Go ahead and bend your knees, take your knees side to side. And that's it. That's it for our floor yoga practice. So we'll close our practice. You can stay on your back if you want to. Thank you all so much.